This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to define the microscopic kinetic energy and the microscopic potential energy, introduce the expression of the total energy of a system, define the energy isolated system, discuss three examples on the energy isolated system.
Thermal energy. Microscopic kinetic energy. On the shown figure, a pot containing cold water is put on fire. The water particles, such as molecules, are in motion. So each of these particles possesses kinetic energy due to its motion. In general, the sum of the kinetic energies of the particles that constitute a system, such as water in this example, is called the microscopic kinetic energy or the thermal energy of the system. But we know that when water gains heat energy and the speed or the agitation of its particles increases, the temperature of water is also increases. Then, as the microscopic kinetic energy of a system or as the thermal energy of a system increases, its temperature increases. Now, how can you warm up your hands without using fire? One of the methods, you can rub your hands against each other. What happens? When you rub your hands, the work done by the friction forces result in an increase in the thermal energy of your hands, so their temperature increases. In general, when the work done by friction forces acting on a system results in an increase of the thermal energy, the temperature of this system rises. Microscopic potential energy. In the shown video, when the temperature of water becomes 100 degrees Celsius at normal atmospheric pressures, it starts boiling and changing into vapor. Even though heat energy is given to water, but its temperature remains constant, and its microscopic kinetic energy also remains constant. The question now, what happens when the system gains heat energy and its microscopic kinetic energy doesn't change? During the change of phase, the distances among the particles increase and the microscopic kinetic energy remains constant. So, the heat energy gained by the water results in an increase of its microscopic potential energy. Then, the microscopic potential energy of a system is restored due to the interaction between its constituent particles. Now, let's take an example about microscopic potential energy. In this figure, the fuel filling the car or the chemical energy in the fuel filling the car is an example of microscopic potential energy, since the force of the engine or the work done by the force of the engine results in a transformation of the chemical energy stored in the fuel into kinetic energy. So chemical energy is an example on microscopic potential energy. Also nuclear energy, another example on microscopic potential energy. Now internal energy. Any system possesses microscopic kinetic energy and microscopic potential energy. The sum of these two energies is called the internal energy of the system. So U, which is the internal energy of the system, equal to the microscopic kinetic energy of the system plus the microscopic potential energy of the system. Note, the microscopic kinetic energy of the system is always positive, and the microscopic potential energy of the system is always positive. Then the internal energy of the system is always positive.
After explaining the internal energy of a system, let's discuss the total energy of a system. The total energy is given by E is equal to ME plus U. E is the total energy of the system, ME is its mechanical energy, and U is its internal energy. Now let's discuss the energy isolated system. Consider a system that does not exchange energy with its surroundings, which means that the system neither gains nor loses energy. to the surrounding. Its total energy must be conserved. Now, in this study, we will call the system as an energy isolated system. So we have E is equal to ME plus U, and this E is constant. Now, when a quantity is constant, then its variation is zero. So delta E is equal to zero. But delta E is equal to delta ME plus delta U. So we have delta ME plus delta U is equal to zero. And finally, the result is delta ME is equal to minus delta U. What does this mean? This means that any increase in the mechanical energy of an energy isolated system is equal to the loss in its internal energy, and vice versa.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's take example about isolated and non-isolated systems. A girl slides down a rough inclined plane. Rough inclined plane means friction exists. The work done by friction results in a transfer of mechanical energy into thermal energy. Thermal energy means the internal energy increases. If we take the system, girl, incline, atmosphere, and air, in this case, the produced thermal energy is gained by the incline and the girl and the atmosphere. Therefore, all the value of the mechanical energy lost by this system is gained as internal energy. Therefore, the total energy of the above system remains constant. Thus, it is an energy isolated system. Now, if we take the system, girl, inclined, air, where the atmosphere is outside the system, but we know that part of the produced thermal energy is gained by the surrounding, which is the atmosphere. So in this case, the mechanical energy lost by the system is not equal to the internal energy gained by the system, because part of the thermal energy gained by the atmosphere, and the atmosphere is outside the system. Therefore, in this case, this system is not energy isolated.
Going to give you an example about an energy isolated system with conserved mechanical energy. Our example is the freely falling object. Consider this apple. It falls under the action of its weight. So we are studying the apple earth system, or the object earth system. Now recall that a freely falling object falls under the action of its weight only. So it is not subjected to air resistance. So delta U is equal to zero. Now take into account, if air resistance is acting on the apple, then the work done by this force would result in a transformation of part of the kinetic energy of the apple into thermal energy. But this is not our case. So recall the formula of the energy isolated system. Delta ME is equal to the negative delta U. Now, replace the value of delta U in the last equation. This will give you delta ME is equal to zero, which means that the mechanical energy is conserved. So this is an example of an energy isolated system with conserved mechanical energy.
Energy isolated system with non-conserved mechanical energy. Example, rocket launch.
As you see, lift off of space shuttle Atlantis on a mission to build, resupply, and to
rocket fuel, atmosphere, air. So this system does not exchange energy with the surrounding. So this system is energy isolated. So we can write the variation in its mechanical energy equal to the negative variation in its internal energy. But during the upward motion, the internal energy of the system decreases due to the fuel combustion. Then delta U does not equal zero, or delta U negative. So using this formula, if delta U does not equal zero, we get delta ME is not equal to zero. Therefore, the mechanical energy is not conserved. So this is an energy isolated system with non-conserved mechanical energy. In this case, the internal energy decreases while the mechanical energy increases.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.